Today I'm going to be breaking down the metaphysical dichotomy between the chosen ones and the NPCs. Now, NPC is a computer-generated spirit, a soulless entity that is being used to carry out the implications for the energy extraction matrix. Now, when you understand the nomenclature title for NPC means non-player character that's connected to the algorithm of the third dimension, which is the foundation of the Metatronic overlay that's connected to the material plane and the physical plane, right? But first, I need you to understand that the entire universe is a holographic simulation, right? And the holographic simulation in itself is based on the entrapment of subatomic particles that contain magnetic fields, right? So you have the entrapment of light that operates on a binary code system of the matrix system, right? Zero is a representation of dark matter energy. The one is a representation of trapped light, which are photons that is basically connected to the grid system, right? The illusion of physical matter. Because when you understand the dynamics of the holographic simulation that we're living in, everything is a representation of the illusion, and the illusion in itself is the physical density that leaves you in a fixed position reality. So the best way to explain it, when you're talking about the illusion of physical matter, you got the photon, hydrogen atom creates electrons, electrons create elements, and elements create molecules, and molecules create organs, and organs create organ systems. So that gives you the illusion of physical matter, to where you're trapped in a mathematical sequence under a dualistic energy, right? There's a delineation between individuality and a personality, right? A personality is based on a form of a psychological egregore. It's a thought form that's connected to the matrix. Individuality is connected to a purpose and is connected to your soul. So the great majority of NPCs, they have personalities. They don't have any individuality. That's why when you see a lot of NPCs, a lot of their mechanisms and their projections of their mental faculties is being facilitated by celebrities, is being facilitated by politicians, is being facilitated by government agents, is being facilitated by everything that's trapped in the illusion of physical matter, right? A lot of people have a misconception about demons. Demons dwell in the false light. They don't dwell in darkness, right? And the false light is being perpetuated by supporting everything around you on the three-dimensional principle, right? Which is the illusion. So if you support everything that's being perpetuated by the system, you know, you don't have any type of spiritual boundaries. This is where you can be infiltrated. So a lot of NPCs, they support mentally hostile, or they become verbally hostile, or they become physically hostile, because it goes against their belief system. It goes against their reality. It goes against their illusion. So when you see a person like me or anybody that's connected to a higher state of consciousness and they're thinking on a higher frequency, when you're speaking to an NPC, you know what I'm saying, it's going to destroy their belief systems, right? So it's a form of a defense mechanism to basically have a stronghold to the system on a emotional level. That's why I said, you know, your emotions is going to deceive you every time. A person would tell you that the sky is green if the color blue hurts their feelings. That's what NPCs do. They're not living in a place of logic and rationality, right?
So when you look at the sciatic nerve, you got your actual L5, your L4, you got your S1, your S2, your S3, and your S4. All right, well, if you look at these things actually form what you would call a nerve branch. The nerve branch then go through the pelvis floor, and it goes through a muscle through your thigh, and it goes down your leg. The sciatic nerve is about 2 millimeters wide, so it's a pretty thick actual nerve that's in the body. Usually what happens is these discs starts to wear out and it becomes a bulging disc. And what happened is when these discs wear out due to acidosis and very, very stagnant dehydration, it starts clamping on the disc. The bones will pinch the disc. Well, usually when the bones pinch the disc, it will actually pinch one of these nerves. Since S1 and S4 branches itself into a branch and create the sciatic nerve, usually it's either pinched in this area, or it get pinched by the inflamed pelvis, or it get pinched by the actual muscle that's in the thigh, and this causes a excruciating shooting pain through your leg. Sometimes it can go through your arms. It can be numbness in your fingertips. You can feel this everywhere throughout your body, because this is a main nerve, and it's actually connected to the vagus nerve too, if we want to be honest, which is the 10th cranial nerve that's in your brain. So in order for you to really fix this disease, you're going to have to bring hydration actually to the spinal column. And the best way to bring hydration to the spinal column is by hydrating the cells. Even though that these are hard calcium matrix or what we call bones, bones are still made of cells. Your whole entire body is made of cells. You have different types of cells depending on the environment and cultural medium or the gene expressions that makes up a nose cell, an ear cell, an eye cell, depending on where they at in the culture medium. So if these are nothing but cells, and we know that cells need water, H3O to be exact, from H3O2 or H2O, it don't matter, then you need to hydrate the body. You need to bring more electrolytes in the body. Also, we're dealing with the bone calcium matrix too. So what deals with the bone calcium matrix is something called calcitonin. And calcitonin is actually made by the parathyroid. So we need to go after the parathyroid as well. You can do natural things like rebounding that will help you move the lymph. You can do things like jump roping that'll help you move the lymph, move your lymphatic system. Another thing is called skin brushing towards the kidneys, not towards the heart. That'll help you move your lymphatic system. Get in the shower, let it be warm for 5 minutes, and then the last 2 minutes before you get out, turn it completely cold. That'll help you move the lymphatic system as well. That's another thing called the low hanging head method, where you will get on a bed or get on a table and you will literally, you will put your head at the end of the table and you will lean your head all the way back and stretch your neck. And as you stretch your neck, you will lift your arms up, and then you will bring your arms down and bring your head up. This will actually take a lot of pressure off the spinal column and maybe move the L5 and the L4 to get that disc to breathe again. You see what I'm saying? And another thing with the sciatic nerve, you can do a heel toe method. Google these things. These things will pop straight up, and you can go to YouTube University. They show you this stuff on YouTube for free. And this is not even mentioned in the herbs. Now, if you want to get into herbs, I would say get into things like turmeric, curcumin, boswellia. That's another good herb. Enzymes from the papaya, which you would call bromelium. These are all good things that will help grow the bone back. These are things that will help regulate the nerves. For the nerves, you got blue vervain. Blue vervain is very, very good for the nerves. Ashwagandha is very good for the nerves and the autonomic nervous system, or what we call the adrenal gland. Bugleweed. Bugleweed is very, very good for the nerves. Lily of the valley herb. Stay away from dairy products. Lactic acid. Stay away from meats. Uric acid. Carbonic acid. And that come from your grains. Carbonic acid. We have to stay away from high carbohydrated foods. And I'm not talking about natural fruits and vegetables. I'm talking about high yielding grains like rice, like spelt, and all that other nasty crap that's in your body. These things will bring on a mucosal response and will completely black up the GOAT. And remember, GOAT stands for gut associated lymphatic tissue. So if I was you, by so far, if you ask me what you need, you're gonna need the actual geogenetic therapeutic package from Off the Site. So y'all gonna love our new charts that's on our document download. We redid all the charts. Everything is back up, family. All right, I love y'all. Peace, love, light, and healing. Peace to the gods, peace to the earth. Peace.
Like, it was a video that I seen on TikTok. It was like maybe like 8 to 10 people that was in the ER, and everything just, they just poof. Like, they, everybody got up in there, and they were just looking like, what's going on? He was like right there.
It was, you see the bus? Did you see the school bus?
I seen the school bus too. Yeah, with the children on it.
So yeah. When the frequency go up, everything don't go with it.
Wow. So these people that's like on a lower frequency, or these people
they warped out of the reality that we moving into because their frequency is not compatible.
That explains a lot of the stuff I've been seeing over there in the Europe and Asia and stuff like that. Cause you see people like just getting up and they act like they see something and spin around, then they just like die. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Right, because they being earth scanned. The earth itself sends out a pulse. Anything don't match the frequency is turning that shit off.
Okay.
By the time the earth get done with natural disasters, man-made disasters, because the man...
All right, so I know I'm always exposing the devils of the industry, but today I want to talk about somebody who gave up the limelight, gave up the spotlight, you know what I'm saying, to go against them. Let's talk about B.O.B. If you don't know who B.O.B. is, you remember the song Nothing on You with Bruno Mars, you know, the other dude on the song, that's B.O.B. And he on the freshman covers, he an up and coming artist, and he blowing up fast, you feel me? And out the blue, he just disappeared, you feel me? Because he didn't want to push the agendas they wanted him to push. He didn't want to sell his soul. And he started dropping little hints and stuff on Twitter, you feel me? Like, making posts saying the earth is really flat. So after folks clown him for saying the earth is flat, he made an album called Earth. And you see how he got the flat earth with the dome around it? That's how it really is. And you know the elites weren't having that. They weren't going for that at all. This is a song on the album called Flatline. I want y'all to pause this video and read those lyrics. He was exposing NASA, he was exposing the elites. I just really want y'all to go listen to the album. The question, I always hear this question. How do you get into the music business? Were you let in or blessed in? I'm guessing I never signed my name in blood or sacrificed my best friend. I got as far as I could go before I hit a dead end. Sit back and let it set in. How do you go from doing songs with T.I. and Kendrick Lamar getting 131 million views? I mean, he even had a song with Lil Wayne at 36 million views, you feel me? How do you go from this to just disappearing, you know what I'm saying? Crazy thing is, he never disappeared though. You feel me? Bruh been dropping music. I'm talking, he got a podcast where he exposing these folks, all type of stuff. But it's not mainstream, you feel me? Like, they blackball, bruh, where we barely can see his stuff. They took all his music off the platforms, all of that stuff, you feel me? Let's get into his most recent music video, How to Make Clones. Talk about this part of the song. They predicted 9/11 20 years before they dropped. Tell me, how was a prediction if they wrote the whole plot? Don't know who behind the curtain, could be bots at the top. The invasion been happened, the bodies already swapped. This is my favorite part of the song right here. Is it just me, or is artificial intelligence mimicking melanin? What if melanated people was somebody's experiment? They hid the ancient temples, then just blamed it on aliens. NASA stole their symbols from an African tribe and acted like it was some they just seen up in the sky. Knew my school wasn't had me reading them lies and had I drinking milk for lunch at 10:45. EMF through your body, iron in your body, silicone in your body, similar to robotics. Now, out of all these rappers that chose the money or was just too scared to go against them, B.O.B. chose to be for us, and that's why I with B.O.B. hard. So protect B.O.B. at all costs.
Top of the afternoon, niggas and niggas. What y'all was doing? I had seen y'all want to go on a little adventure with me, travel the world with a bitch and whatnot. So I'm like, okay, cool. I had wanted to go to Greece, but then I had seen one of y'all in the comments say, let's go to Maui. And I was like, that's a beautiful idea because we need to raise awareness. What the fuck is this though, y'all? What the fuck? What in the San Andreas? Like, this look like Grand Theft Auto. Come on now, Google Maps. Y'all gonna need to get together. But that wasn't even where we were supposed to be at, bitch. I was all the way in Kahula somewhere. We need to go to Lahaina. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. But that's where the fire started. So this was very interesting to me. So when I click on a satellite view, look at that, y'all. Everything is fucked up. It showed like how really fucked up it is when you click on a satellite view. But when you click on a street view, everything is as it should be. Which is really fucking bittersweet to me because it's like we can see what it used to be. And now we can see what the fuck it is now. Look at that, y'all. All those buildings, businesses, churches, schools, like everything, homes, gone, cars, people. Look, it goes for miles and miles and miles and miles, y'all. This literally made me cry. I literally was just crying before I made this video because when you see it, like, from this perspective, y'all, the street view, look at this. People sitting by the pool, palm trees. It's beautiful. They living life, not even knowing that the government was going. Let me shut the fuck up. Because why would y'all turn the water off? If you listen to what the locals was saying, they turned the water off. Listen to the locals, y'all. Fuck what I'm saying. Listen to the locals. Listen to what the natives is saying. Oh, Lord. A school, y'all. This is what made me cry. Look at this elementary school. Can you imagine the kids? I clicked on the street view because I wanted to see what it looked like, y'all. It's beautiful. Look at the playground. I just imagine just kids playing and oh my gosh. like, let's just continue to keep them lifted in our prayers, y'all, please. Because I just can't imagine the pain of seeing my whole city. The whole city is gone, y'all. And I really feel like the government has something to do with this, because they'll do that. If they wanted that land bad enough, they'll do it. Remember what they did to the Chagosian people so they could get Diego Garcia? Yeah, we ain't forgot. Let's continue to pray for them, though, y'all.
Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say we were free. Strange things
have. You cannot move water around in your body or retain it in the right compartments inside your blood vessels, inside your tissues, inside the cells. You can't keep things in the right compartment without sodium chloride. The chief cells in your stomach cannot make stomach acid without salt. Okay? Salt is a raw material. Sodium chloride is a raw material to make hydrochloric acid. So, two things have happened because of this terrible criminal advice that doctors have given. It's criminal. Anybody else do this to the American people, they'd be put in jail for life. Some of them would be executed because of the number of people who are killed over this. Right? Salt is required to make stomach acid. You don't have enough stomach acid, you get reflux, incorrectly called acid reflux. Is reflux. Mm-hmm. Reflux is caused by insufficient amounts of stomach acid, not too much stomach acid. So doctors even named it the wrong thing, right? And basically, you get reflux when you don't have enough stomach acid to keep your stomach environment sterile. So yeast begin to grow in there, so you eat carbohydrates and sugar. They ferment that, produce gas, heartburn, pressure, reflux. Because you have all these things growing in your stomach. Okay, when you get a pH too high, you get a pH above 4, all these things begin to grow. You have a pH under 1, your pepsin works to digest proteins, and you can absorb minerals, you can absorb B12. Your pH gets above 2, 2.5, you can't do that. Okay, so you're in trouble. I mean, you can take tons of iron supplementation, and if you don't have any stomach acid, you can't absorb iron. Now, here comes the most terrible thing that's happened to America because of this inappropriate advice. Well, there's two things. One, you go back to 1995, 750 people died during a triple-digit heat wave in Chicago. It was a two-week heat wave, 1995, I believe it was. 750 people died here in Chicago, and thousands of people fell out with heat stroke. The first thing they give them intravenously on the way to the hospital, they get heat stroke, is saline solution, which is
salt water,
yeah. And it's absolutely criminal that these 750 people who died were all ones who were on assault-restricted diet. They're all seniors who were on assault-restricted diet. They died of heat stroke because these doctors didn't have the courtesy to call these people up in good manners, just to call up and say, look, whether you believe in the assault-restricted diet or not, right now you need to put a couple of tablespoons of salt in a gallon of water and be sipping on that until the heat wave goes away. But they didn't do that. And so all those people who died of heat stroke were under the care of doctors who were on a restricted salt diet, those doctors should be put in jail. Okay? For almost like the same thing as vehicular homicide, the same type of thing as manslaughter, right? Type of thing. Then here comes the big one. Right now,
isn't it ironic that Whitney Houston dies the same way that Jimi Hendrix dies? In a tub in a hotel, allegedly from drugs. And we know why Jimi Hendrix was murdered, the greatest guitarist of all time, because Jimi Hendrix wanted to finance the Black Panther Party, but he didn't know that his agent, his manager, was an MI6 British intelligence agent.
What? Damn. So,
and Prince was murdered because Prince didn't want to sell his unpublished music to Warner Brothers. And Michael Jackson was murdered because he didn't want to sell the Beatles catalog back to Sony Records.
What you want to ask for?
And R. Kelly went to jail because Sony Records wanted his catalog. Yeah. R. Kelly is not in jail for pedophilia, although that's wrong, and he should be if he's guilty. But that ain't why he there. Yeah. White folks been knew he was doing what he was doing. R. Kelly didn't go to jail till R. Kelly start questioning control of his masters. Bill Cosby goes to jail because the second largest oil company in the world wanted to drill under his home in Massachusetts, and he wouldn't let him. And the reason they brought up the lawsuit with the ugly old white women is to financially bankrupt Bill Cosby, so he got to sell the house and the oil company gets the oil.
You sold the house?
I don't know. Damn, but he out of jail, though.
Yeah, jail, no.
This is how the world's gonna look. Say, for instance, you have motion sensors all over the highways and the freeways. And you're in your car, and all of a sudden, your car wiggles on the road. Well, they're gonna send a hologram drone to your car, and it's done. He's gonna come, and he's gonna scan your body to see if you were on drugs or anything. And this is how they know if you did something illegal. Then they're gonna notify the real cop cars to come, because in the future, there will be no more judges, no more juries, no more executioners. This will be on you if you can't behave yourself. Because in the future, what they're going to do is bring you in when you create a violation or commit a felony. They're going to bring you in on a gurney, put a microchip the size of a pinhead in the delicate part of your brain. It's a LoJack, because it can take the ankle bracelet from here. This little chip in your brain, they can track you via satellite. So that means that the satellites can actually see where you are if you go to Moscow or New York or to London. They can actually zoom in on you and videotape you committing a crime. So they don't have to take you to court now. They have actual everything on you videotape. Then they're gonna send a drone transporter to pick you up. The drone transporters are going to be bigger in the future. They're little now, but they're going to be major in the future. So they'll send a drone transporter. You won't even hear it. It'll come, and it'll be silence. It'll land. It'll open up like a giant claw, suck you in, and sedate you on the way back to Homeland Security. This is true. This is real technology, alien technology that's coming. It's in my Matrix 4 book. They're talking about the new technology that's 10 to 15 years ahead that you need to be prepared for. That's why you see movies and you see new technology in the movie, is to shift your consciousness and to help you to adapt to what's coming.
What you're doing on the streets? Don't you know Dance Gazebo is on?
Dance Gazebo?
Dance Gazebo. It's required viewing by all subjects of Retroville, along with Dance Airport, Dance Grocery Store, and Dance Dance Hall.
Oh, yeah, Dance Hall. It's my favorite.
That was a test. There is no Dance Dance Hall. That's ridiculous. I must report your crime to her most terrible dictatorship so that she may pass an incredibly fair yet monstrously brutal judgment.
Libby? Libby's the future dictator of Retroville?
Check her out. Most people couldn't pull off the future dictator look.
My mom says we should trust policemen.
Did she specifically mention giant four-armed robot policemen?
No!
They keep running!
Our faces in the rocks, there are hieroglyphs in the rocks. That right there that I'm pointing to is an entrance to an ancient temple. It's an ancient temple right there. It's a portal. This is the Atlantean Empire right here.
This is Wet Beaver Creek, found in Sedona, Arizona. Pictoglyphs are all over this area. This area still has a sundial that still predicts to this day all four seasons of the year. The name Anusazi was coined by the Navajo Indians and means the ancient ones who weren't us. They were saying they didn't write the pictoglyphs and they didn't build the sundial. They weren't us. We know the truth now.
Last time I saw my son Tupac was in a hospital bed in Las Vegas, Nevada. I just got off the plane and after I greeted everybody in the waiting emergency room. And when I walked through the doors, I saw something that resembled my son, but really didn't look like my son the last time I saw him.
Actually, we're kind of pretty far down the street when it happened. We didn't know if we heard gunshots or we didn't really know exactly what we heard. We heard a lot of screaming, a lot of cars screeching. We were just hanging out, taking photos at the time. We ran up the street as cops were running past us. And by the time we got here, they were already taking, which now I found out was Tupac, into the helicopter away. He had been shot.
So Kanye West is just spilling, some tea, apparently from an unreleased clip from 2018, but we now get to see it. And he just exposed Cardi B, Corey Gamble, the industry. Y'all, y'all look at this.
Yes, Corey and CIA. Like, he didn't even have to say it. I know it. You fucking CIA. What are you talking about? Like, what the fuck? Oh, the, oh, this is my godmother. This is my this. These Illuminati. That's why fucking Cardi B was over there. Cardi B is a plant by the Illuminati. She don't write her raps. She's just there to, like, sound as ignorant as possible. And then make songs like fuck him and you get some money.
Yeah.
You know, she was literally replaced, you know, Nicki Minaj purposely. That they put her there. And now she doesn't know what to do. And she's just a fucking, she has no idea what the fuck is going on. She thinks it's just a blessing from the universe. There ain't no blessing from the fucking universe. You know?
Slave collar. After I do my demonstration, I'll pass it around.
March first is without borders.
Let me walk upon the waters.
Wherever you would call me, and take me deeper than my feet could ever wander. And my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. And Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters, wherever you would call me. And take me deeper than my feet could ever wander. And my faith will be made stronger.
special cuts on the album. You got,
CIA killed me.
Special cut on the album. What's the special cut?
They got two.
Oh, yeah. You got two special cuts on the album. You got,
CIA killed me.
Let us make man in our image. The us was Zeus with the other fallen gods in the lab creating the human beings. In us, in our image, you were made in our image. This is where you get all your shit from. Your arm, leg, leg, arm, head. See? But Zeus was only able to give you the physical aspect of us. A lot of the genetic inner workings, he couldn't replicate that. And that's the only difference between a human being and a god. We both look alike. You see? So we can walk amongst each other and they lied about history, so we think we all one human race. Because we look alike. But internally, we have two completely different inner workings. Two completely different genetics. We completely different species. We not from here neither. Human beings, you're not from here. But you were created somewhere else. And that's okay. And then you came here. But us, these so-called, that's been labeled blacks and Latinos, we not from here neither. And the difference is we created here, there, 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 the entire multiverse. This is why your species, because if you're a human being and you're here, that means you're vibrating high. But I'm talking about your species, the hierarchy human beings, the low vibrational, not the racist human beings, not the good ones. This is why your people attacked us. And continue to attack us to this day. All behind these genetics.
I wrote an article last night that I want to recite to you.
Okay.
How does a baby learn? A baby learns through mimicking. They just mimic. They mimic their parents. They mimic everything until they can start to mimic words. Once they start mimicking words, they start mimicking more words. And then they start mimicking sentences.
Yes.
Once they're mimicking full sentences and they understand mimicking and words in general and letters and how they work together, they become their own individual speaker. They become these intricate thinkers and speakers on their own, but only after they've been allowed to mimic unjudged. They have to be, you have to look at everybody as a child.
Yeah.
They have to be able to mimic their parents unjudged until they find themselves. That's what it's all about. I used to mimic Tyler, bro. I still do.
Really?
Kanye. I still do.
But...
you know what I'm saying? And I have to go through that in order to understand, this is me. I'm finding myself through them. I'm taking bits and pieces of everything everywhere and I'm creating myself.
Yeah.
Misfits to me is somebody that can make the life that they want for themselves.
Yeah.
And do what they want for themselves and find what they want for themselves and be their own person by creating.
You're
being your own person not by, being a part of this or doing this or doing that, but by being a part of a collective that knows that they support you and it's like, we're okay with you being individual. We're never gonna look at you weird. You know what I'm saying? That's all that Misfits is as a collective. As an individual, on an individual level, it's I'm gonna create whatever I want. Like you. You're filming something.
Yeah.
You're just doing random stuff. You flew here, your parents don't know where you're at.
Don't say that. No, it's on camera. Don't say that. Don't say
all
that.
Right? That's what it's all about. You know what I mean? So it's about creating what you want. Like Momo, like whatever the hell he's wearing, and he started his own brand.
Yes.
That's why he's so cool. You know what I'm saying? Because he started his own thing, but it's all together at the end of the day. Like, there's no difference between Mr. Sharp and MDDM because we're all together. The difference from being an individual and not being an individual is when you're trying to copy somebody, you do not know that you're an individual. But when you know, you know.
Dude, that's why you exist. You exist to be yourself.
But
because
you can't not be yourself is what I'm trying to say to you.
Yeah.
Even if you try to copy
Drake,
if I try to copy
you'll be
Drake,
yourself copying
Kanye,
them.
You'll be yourself copying
them.
You'll be yourself copying them.
Yeah. Okay.
Dude, I genuinely cannot tell what age you are. You look so young but old at the same time. There's actually a really good explanation for that. But you wouldn't believe me. But I'll try you. I'm gonna try you. You actually wouldn't be the first person I tried to tell. Okay, you ready? I'm a vampire. You see? You wanna swipe away right now because of what I just said. Why? Because you don't believe me. Because everything you know and has been told to you about vampires has led you to believe that vampires are fake. Fiction. Right? Remember I said, you're not the first person I tried to tell, right? What if the reason why you all don't believe vampires exist is because every time a vampire, like myself, has said, I'm a vampire, you didn't believe them. And that's why you think it doesn't exist, because of your ignorance. You don't believe me, right? There you go. Like, you know, it's a vicious cycle. Like, I don't know how to get out of it. I've been trying to tell people about myself for about 152, 53 years. What if I told you I'm 362 years old? I've lived many of lives. I'm in my 11th life. What I mean by my 11th life is I've been known as many other names besides Damo. Who I am now is a man born in, what's my fake birthday? 1987. I was born in 1987. In 1987, I was doing coke lines off of Eddie Murphy's VIP table in Studio 54. Nefarious. The 80s were different, baby. The 80s were different. And you still don't believe me. No, I get it. I've been dealing with this for a very, very, very long time. All I can do is just give you information. Oh, for instance, the reason why I look young but old at the same time is because certain things age on vampires and certain things don't. Fun fact about vampires, we have the ability, as we consume blood, we have the ability to start reverting back to our younger selves. However, not everything reverts back to our younger selves, i.e. the patch that I have here. But my face is actually reverting back to a teenager's face. That's why I'm dealing with some acne right now. That certain side effects, you know, depends on the type of blood you drink. You know, I like O positive, but you know. Yeah, so hope that helps. It's time to go hunting soon. Getting kind of hungry. Oh, and we don't always have to drink the blood of humans, man. Like, you know, I could go get a rabbit real quick, get a quick snack. Like, you know, this is probably another reason why we don't want to come out to y'all, because, you know, y'all would try to kill us. You know, you would fail. But, you know, you don't got to worry about none of that, you know, because we're pretty chill, as long as you chill.
I need to stop smoking this shit here.
Okay.
I kind of feel like the more I show you, the more you guys won't believe me. But it's okay. I'm used to this now. This is me in 1919, I believe. I was trying to be an actor. I've always been trying to make my way into film. Even
100 years ago. I kind of switched over to screenwriting, as some of you might know, just because it's a hard industry to crack, you know. Back then, they didn't really allow too many black people in silent films, you know, so you really had to be animated to kind of let them know what you're capable of, you know. I look back at this picture now and I hate it, you know, like I feel like I'm pandering to a certain demographic to so that I can fulfill my dreams. Yeah, I hate it. But yeah, that's me. That's me.
So Obama scares the director of a new movie that's supposed to be released later this year. It's a non-fictional apocalyptic movie that's based off a 2020 novel. Now, the name of this movie is Leave the World Behind. And it is the very first fictional movie executive produced by Obama and Michelle through the Higher Ground Productions. Okay? So this movie, Leave the World Behind, is the same as the movies Left Behind. They reworded it. This is his version of the movies Left Behind. Also, many may not know that they have their own production company called Higher Ground Productions. And it makes me think of Isaiah 14, 14. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. So it is very eerie that their first movie produced is an end time, so-called fictional apocalyptic movie that is supposed to be very realistic. So let's read how he scared the director of this film. I'm writing what I thought is fiction for the most part. I'm trying to keep it as true to life as possible, but I'm exaggerating, dramatizing, Ishmael explained. And to hear an ex-president say you're off by a few details, I thought I was off by a lot, but the fact that he said that scared the living daylights out of me. I wonder how Obama knows how the end time is going to play out. So this movie will have its world premiere on October the 25th during the AFI Fest, and is fully scheduled to be released on December the 8th on Netflix. So this is something to look forward to very soon.